Hello and welcome to another episode of Amazing Aircraft, where we explore the history and performance of some of the most incredible flying machines ever built. Today, we are going to talk about the Sukhoi Su-27, a Soviet origin twin-engine supermaneuverable fighter aircraft that was designed to challenge the US fourth generation jet fighters. We will cover the development, design, variants, operators, and combat record of the Su-27, as well as some of its unique features and capabilities. So buckle up and get ready for a thrilling ride with the Su-27 Flanker. The Su-27 project began in 1969, when the Soviet Union learned of the US Air Force's FX program, which resulted in the F-15 Eagle. The Soviet leadership realized that they needed a better balanced fighter with both good agility and sophisticated systems to counter the new American threat. They issued a requirement for a perspectivni front avoy estrebitel, or PFI, which means advanced front line fighter. The specifications were extremely ambitious, calling for long range, good short field performance, excellent agility, and heavy armament. The aerodynamic design was largely carried out by TSAGI, the Central Aero Hydrodynamic Institute, in collaboration with the Sukhoi Design Bureau. The first prototype, called T-10, flew in 1977, but it was plagued by problems and crashed twice. The fly-by-wire control system was unreliable. The engines were underpowered, and the airframe was overweight. Extensive redesigns followed, leading to a revised version called T-10S, which made its first flight in 1981. This version evolved into the definitive Su-27 configuration. The Su-27 had the Soviet Union's first operational fly-by-wire control system, based on Sukhoi's experience with the T for Bomber project. Combined with relatively low wing loading and powerful basic flight controls, it made for an exceptionally agile aircraft, controllable even at very low speeds and high angle of attack. In air shows, the aircraft has demonstrated its maneuverability with a Cobra or dynamic deceleration. Briefly sustained level flight at a 120 angle of attack. This is one of the tests for supermaneuverability, which means the ability to execute tactical maneuvers that are not possible with purely aerodynamic techniques. The Su-27 also had a sophisticated avionics suite, including a phase, Otron and 001 Mike coherent pulse Doppler radar with track while scan and look down, shoot down capability. The radar could detect targets up to 200 kilometers away and engage the target simultaneously. The fighter also had an OLS-27 infrared search and track system in the nose just forward of the cockpit with an 80 to 100 kilometers range. The Su-27 was armed with a single 30mm Gryazov-Shipunov GSH-301 cannon in the starboard windroof and had up to 10 hard points for missiles and other weapons. Its standard missile armament for air-to-air combat was a mixture of R-73 and R-7 missiles, the latter including extended range and infrared homing models. The Su-27 entered service with the Soviet Air Forces in 1985. It was intended as a direct competitor for the large US fourth generation jet fighters such as the Grumman F-14 Tomcat and McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle. It also had a long-range air defense role against US strategic bombers such as the Rockwell B-1B Lancer and Boeing B-50 to Stratofortress. The Su-27's basic design is aerodynamically similar to the MiG-29, but it is substantially larger. The wing blends into the fuselage at the leading edge extensions and is essentially a cross between a swept wing and a crop delta. The fighter is also an example of a tailed delta wing configuration, retaining conventional horizontal tailplanes. This design gives the Su-27 a high lift-to-drag ratio, which means it can generate more lift with less drag, improving its performance and fuel efficiency. The wing also has large leading edge slats and trailing edge flaps for enhanced low-speed handling and landing. The Su-27 is powered by the Saturn AL-31F, afterburning turbofan engines, each producing up to 122.6 kilonewtons of thrust with afterburner. The engines are located in separate pods under the wing roots, with a tunnel between them that acts as an additional lifting surface and hides armament from radar. The engines have variable geometry nozzles that can adjust the direction and shape of the exhaust flow, enhancing maneuverability and stability. The engines also have a digital control system that automatically adjusts the fuel flow and nozzle position to optimize performance. The Su-27 is equipped with a Phase-O-Tron N001 Mich coherent, pulse Doppler radar with track while scan and look down, shoot down capability. The radar can detect targets up to 200 kilometers away and engage the target simultaneously. The fighter also has an OLS-27 infrared search and track system in the nose just forward of the cockpit with an 80 to 100 kilometers range. This system can provide passive targeting information without emitting any signals that could reveal the Su-27's position. The Su-27 also has a helmet-mounted sight that allows the pilot to aim missiles by looking at the target. The Su-27 is armed with a single 30mm Gryazov-Shipunov GSH-301 cannon in the starboard wingroot and has up to 10 hard points for missiles and other weapons. Its standard missile armament for air-to-air combat is a mixture of R-73 and R-7 missiles, including extended range and infrared homing models. The R-73 is a short-range missile with high agility and off-bore sight capability, meaning it can be fired at targets that are not directly in front of the aircraft. The R-7 is a medium-range missile with semi-active radar or infrared guidance, depending on the variant. The Su-27 can also carry unguided air-to-ground rockets, conventional bombs, and cluster bombs for ground attack missions. The Su-27 was developed into a family of aircraft. These include the Su-30, a two-seat multi-role fighter, the Su-33, a naval fleet defense interceptor, the Su-34, a side-by-side deceit strike, fighter bomber, and the Su-35, an improved air superiority and multi-role fighter. A thrust vectoring version was created, called the Su-37. The Shenyang J-11, a Chinese license-built version of the Su-27. Let's start with the Su-30, which is based on the Su-27 UB-2-seat trainer. The Su-30 has a longer range and can perform air-to-air and air-to-surface missions. It has canards for additional lift and thrust vectoring nozzles for enhanced maneuverability. It also has an in-flight refueling probe and improved avionics. It has been exported to several countries such as China, India, Malaysia, Algeria, and Venezuela. The Su-33 is the naval version of the Su-27 for carrier operations. It has folding wings, canards, and arresting gear for carrier operations. It also has an upgraded radar and fire control system that allows it to use the R-77 missile. It is operated by the Russian Navy from its sole aircraft carrier Admiral Kuznetsov. The Su-34 is a two-seat strike, fighter-bomber variant, with side-by-side seating in a large cockpit. It has a redesigned nose and tail section, enlarged fuel tanks, additional armor protection, advanced electronic warfare systems, and a rear-facing radar. It can carry a variety of air-to-ground weapons, such as smart bombs and anti-ship missiles. It is intended to replace the Su-24 in the Russian Air Force. The Su-35 is an advanced single-seat multi-role fighter with improved engines, radar, avionics, and reduced radar cross-section. It is considered a 4-plus generation fighter, bridging the gap between the Su-27 and the Su-57 stealth fighter. It has been exported to China, Indonesia, and Egypt. The Su-27 is an experimental technology demonstrator with thrust vectoring nozzles made of titanium rather than steel, and an updated airframe containing a high proportion of carbon fiber and alloy. It also has a digital fly-by-wire system and a glass cockpit. It was used to test new technologies and maneuvers for future Su-27 variants. The export version of the Su-27 is known as the Su-27SK, which has a reinforced landing gear and a modified radar. It has been sold to China, Vietnam, Ethiopia, and Indonesia. The two-seat trainer version is known as the Su-27 UBK. The Su-30 MK is an export variant of the Su-30, with different levels of capability for different customers. Versions include Su-30 MKA for Algeria, the Su-30 MKI for India, Su-30 MKK for China, Su-30 MKM from Malaysia. The Su-27 entered service with the Soviet Air Forces in 1985. After the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, Russia inherited most of the Su-27 fleet and continued to develop and produce new variants. Other former Soviet republics that operate or operated the Su-27 include Ukraine, Belarus, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and Moldova. China was the first foreign operator of the Su-27 and the only country to acquire the fighter before the fall of the Soviet Union. China also produces its own version of the Su-27 as the J-11. Other countries that have bought or received the Su-27 or its variants include Angola, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Algeria, Malaysia, Venezuela, and Vietnam. The Su-27 has been used in various conflicts and exercises around the world. Here are some examples. The Su-27 was used by both sides. In the Eritrean-Ethiopian War in 1998 to 2000, where Ethiopian Su-27s shot down four Eritrean MiG-29s and damaged another one. The Ethiopian Air Force also used its Su-27s in Somalia. In the late 2000s and 2010s, bombing Islamist targets and patrolling the airspace. The Russian Air Force used its Su-27s in Syria since 2015, as part of its intervention in the Syrian civil war. The Su-27s provided air cover for Russian bombers and ground forces, as well as escorting humanitarian aid flights. The Ukrainian Air Force used the Su-27s to intercept Russian fighter jets over its airspace during the 2014 annexation of Crimea and subsequent war in Donbas. The Ukrainian Su-27s also participated in joint exercises with NATO allies such as Poland, Romania, Turkey, and the United States. The Indonesian Air Force participated for the first time in the biennial exercise Pitch Black exercise in Australia with its Su-27s in 2012. The exercise involved air-to-air and air-to-ground missions with other participating countries such as Singapore, Thailand, New Zealand, and the United States. The Sukhoi Su-27 is a remarkable aircraft that has withstood the test of time and proven its versatility and agility in various scenarios. It is still one of the premier fighters of many countries and continues to evolve with new technologies and capabilities. It has spawned a family of aircraft with different roles and missions, such as the Su-30, Su-33, Su-34, Su-35, and Su-37. It has also been involved in several conflicts and exercises around the world, demonstrating its superiority and reliability. It has earned the respect of friend and foe alike. It is truly a legend in the sky. That's all for this video. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please give us a thumbs up and share this video with your friends. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos on aviation and aerospace. Thanks for watching and see you next time.